Yes, a lot of times women, of course, want their men to be more sensitive. And what I've heard happens a lot is when that happens, so they'll be in a relationship with a man and he will start to show his sensitive side, but suddenly it kind of goes too much over into the sensitivity, shall we say, and it becomes something else. And that then may repel the woman because, after all, you know, she's not here to take care of him, you know, as a mother would her son. And therein lies the issue, I believe, is that it exists for women and it exists also for men. And it's like, this is the whole reason that we need to heal ourselves before we get into a relationship, or as we're getting into a relationship, at the same time that both people come into its responsibility. It says, okay, I recognize that I have these woundings, right? I call them woundings, for lack of a better term. I have these woundings, and I'm working on them, okay? So if you see me kind of shift, and I go a little bit too much over into the emotional area, then don't be alarmed. But I need to process that. I recognize that I need to process that on my own, that's not your job. It's not your job to process it. And if you don't want to process it with me, that's fine, I understand. See, the whole thing about communication, it gives us an opportunity, deeper communication gives us an opportunity to step into that place that I call deeper responsibility. Deeper responsibility, we don't expect anybody, we don't have conditions and expectations on the other person to pick us up, shake us off. Be there, yes. Have compassion, yes. Be supportive, yes. But not in a way that feeds into the frailties or the weaknesses. But rather that says, okay, I'm going to hold with you. I see what you're going through right now. I understand that. I see it. And I'll be here. I can't do it for you. I can't do it for you. Nor am I going to, because I've got my own stuff that I'm working on. So I think each individual has to come into that place. It's like, okay, this is where I am right now. I've got A, B, and C that I'm still working on. And the other person has A, B, and C that they're working on. And sometimes what happens is that the frequency shifts when a person is working on a wounding or an event that happened in their lives, a trauma, and it's not the time for the other person to be there because it matches or it mirrors too much what they're going through. Sometimes that mirror can work. In other words, if you're working at an issue and I have a similar issue, it's like when we can have dialogue about it, we can actually work it out. But sometimes it's too much. And I think the wise person says it's too much right now. And I'm going to back off a little bit. This is nothing personal. I love you. It's not personal. But I need the space in which to heal this. And I see that you need the space in which you can heal that. And then if there's a way, or when there's a way, or a time that we can come back together, beautiful. Then we'll be that much more anchored in who we really are.